Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, The Legend of Heroes, Part 3, technically. Oh, we gotta watch at the bow for enemy ships, or I guess any ships at all. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, so welcome back and stuff. Here's Chris. Well, Chris, viewer says, I can't believe it. Okay, you're not watching for ships at this point, Yurio. I'll take the clothes in as quickly as Basray did. Watch, Yurio. Chris, be careful. She's distracting him. I'm okay. You know how good I am at climbing trees. He's supposed to be watching for ships, and he's not. I can see it coming now. Wow. I lost my balance a little, but the clothes are all in. I guess you had a basket or something? I don't care. What happens if you get hurt? Here we are. You're so kind. If you get hurt, I must carry you all the way to Aldos. So that's why you were worried about me. Are you mad? A little. I'm going back to the kitchen now. Don't be lazy. Okay. I'll go back to my watch, too. Dun-dun, danger, I bet. Oh, here come those other two. To distract him even more. Logi and Tess. Yurio! What is it? I want to talk to Captain Jilba. Can you take me to him? Of course, let's go right now. Yurio, you can't leave your post! Yurio! Captain Jilba says, so you're saying that while you were lounging in the lobby, Tess's coat disappeared? Tess says, what an important coat, because Logi bought it for me on my honeymoon. Is there anything else missing other than the coat? Well, the pocket watch I left in the cabin is also missing. We may have misplaced one of them, but... Yurio says, I can't believe we have a thief on the ship. Everyone on the ship is nice. You haven't met two of them. Not properly, anyway. Logi says, I sure feel the same way, but I thought we should talk to the captain. Thank you for informing us. I can't believe we have a thief on the ship, now Jilba says it. I'll check again. There may be places I haven't looked. Tess says, sorry to trouble you. We'll do our best to find your missing belongings. Arr. Captain Jilba? It's a problem. Yurio, thank you. Take a rest for a while. Tell Garten to get back to the bow. But what happened in the meantime? If there's a thief on the ship, it will be a big problem, but everyone's busy doing their own thing. Ah, Yurio, sorry to bother you after your watch shift. Can you do some investigation for me? Yes. I'm sure they're somewhere. I'll go find them. Do the best you can. It will help Logi and his wife, and also me. Yes, sir! Day one. Day two. Another fine day. Pilgrims Yurio and Chris are good, hard-working kids. If things go smoothly, we'll arrive at Neri early morning of day three. My blessings to the pilgrims. By the way, the couple in the Class 2 cabin have never come out of their room. They must be very shy. I wouldn't say that's exactly true that they're shy, but... They're probably also the thieves that they're talking about. Tirasweel is a big region. As the mayor said, our trip may really take us 3 months. Indeed. I was supposed to go tell him to take over the watch, but nobody's been watching while we were over... Okay, where is he? Yo, Garten! Yo, Song Dude. Song Dude. Are you Garten? No, you're Bolto. The belongings of the newlyweds are gone? I hope it's some kind of mistake. It is no mistake, my sir. Where are Chris and the lead chef? Oh, here they come. Excuse me. Yo-Yo says, "Where were you?" to Chris. "I've been to the ship's hold." Oh no! What? "The fish I left here is missing." Yo-Yo says, "Do you suspect me?" "Confess!" "My god. When I came in, the fish was already gone. I'm telling the truth." "Well, no matter how hungry you are, you can't eat raw fish." "Alright, I believe you." "You should have believed me in the first place. By the way, Chris, come with me." "What is it, Yo-Yo? You're so secretive." "The fish is not the only thing missing around here. Tess's coat and Loji's watch are also missing." "Really? So there is a thief?" "We don't know yet." "I can't believe there's a thief on this ship. We keep saying that." "You're right. Everyone is nice here." "So that too. I promise the captain I'll find the thief." "That's my Yo-Yo. Now wait for me here." "I'm gonna wait for you there. I'm supposed to get the thief." "Lead chef!" "What is it, Chris?" "I'll go find the missing fish." "It must be a rat," the chef says. "Don't worry. I am the daughter of a chapel family, so I can't let even a small problem go unsolved." "Yo-Yo, let's go back to our room and change our clothes." "Why? Can I just wear this?" "Because finding the missing stuff is a task we should tackle as pilgrims." "You're so picky about some things." "There we are. Chris, are you ready?" "Don't peek." "Well, there's no window. We can't peek on this cabin." Yo-Yo says, "Why should I peek when you're getting changed?" "Oh, Yo-Yo, he's so innocent." "Oh! Thanks for the vote of confidence." Yo-Yo and Chris teamed up to help Loji and Tess and to find the fish. Well, we know it's in there. But I'm gonna check around everywhere else first, because you know me. There might be more dialogues to pick up. This looks important over here with this guy. It's locked. Let's talk to Mr. Heston, too. Excuse me, Mr. Heston? Hello, sailor and lady chef. May I help you? Mr. Heston, have you noticed anything strange? Anything strange? No, not that I know of. What happened? Oh. Sorry to keep you standing like that. Please come in. Don't be shy. Come in. Okay, we're coming in. So tell me what happened. Chris says, asked, "Do you have anything belonging missing from your belongings?" "Anything missing? As a matter of fact, I have. I can't find my gold brooch." "I'm not worried about it too much, though. I think I misplaced it somewhere." "Your gold brooch is missing?" They looked at Heston's collar and found no gold brooch there. "Don't worry, miss. It's nothing to lose sleep over. It didn't cost me much. But I'd rather talk about your silver dagger. Do you always carry it with you? I think that's dangerous. You might drop it into the sea by accident. It'll be safer if you keep it in your cabin." "No, don't keep it in the cabin." Chris says, "You have a point." Yo-Yo says, "I'll let you know as soon as I find your gold brooch." "Don't put it in the cabin." Heston says, "Thank you. I've already given up, so don't worry about it too much." "You do not put that in the cabin." "The missing brooch is not expensive, so don't worry." "Yeah, probably not to him. To us, it's probably very expensive." "That bag is very important. I don't even let my wife touch it. Do you understand?" "I want it." So his brooch is missing as well. There's someone in here. Loji says, "I'm sorry to trouble you, but that pocket watch is very important to me." Tess. Chris, you came too. Sorry for the inconvenience. Don't mention it. A gift from someone you love must be very important. Indeed. Oh my god, what happened here? Not dead, I hope. He is sound asleep. Was he saying go pee? Yeah, he has been sleeping for a while. It's a bit strange. I wonder if they put something in his, food or something. Just checking here. Well, I like the way we can just jump over that. Whoop! Alright, down we go. I'll check there last. Oh, it wants me to go in here. Well, check both of those last. Does anything about? No. We still can't get past that stuff. You and Chris are a good team. Good luck. Can't get past. Okay, let's go back to our cabin. See why we must go in there. Hey, Yo-Yo, do you want to leave the silver dagger in the room? No, don't do it. Don't fall asleep. No, I'm thinking. Thinking of what? Something. What is it? I don't understand. Don't get mad. I think I should carry it with me for now. Alright, if you say so. It'll be your fault if you ever lose it. Yet, don't put it in the room. That's too much. Do you have a problem? Now, the only actual problem is the people next door from us are probably hearing this entire conversation. So they know that Yo-Yo has a dagger, and they'll be coming for him. No, I'll be careful. Ugh. We haven't even met them yet. Wasn't sure whether to check the window first or the door. Chris says maybe it's an good opportunity for us to check them out. Excuse me. Shirley says they're back. Oh, please. Not again. I'm already fed up being cramped inside this cabin. Excuse me, Chris says. Those noisy kids. I'm so sorry, but my partner is seasick and not in any condition to go out. Chris asks, are you okay? Shall we bring you medicine? Don't worry. He's a tough guy. Alright then. Take care. How'd you come up with that story? Goose says. Your voice sounded different, too. I'm an intelligent lady, unlike you. Well, he's not a lady. They've never come out of that room, so I think we should rule them out. Do not rule them out. Rule them all the way in. That boy is here. Sheila says, well, at least we can lose some weight. By running to the door? Don't come too close, Sheila says. I don't like it either, but I have no choice. Well, I can see them from here. Can't we see them from here? It's the second day. They're still in their room. I can't help but think about them. We cannot rule them out. How can we find out? I'm sure they're the ones stealing everything. Bosray says, come to think of it, I smell fish. Didn't smell anything before. We are on the open ocean, but yeah, maybe you smell the stolen fish. Yo-Yo says, what's wrong? Well, I had a chat with the lead chef a short while ago. When I came back, I noticed this fishy smell. You're right, Chris says. I smell fish. Maybe it's the fish that disappeared from the kitchen. Maybe, Yo-Yo says. If so, there must be a thief nearby. Gulp. Bosray says, hi. Hey, why are you silent all of a sudden? What was that swallowing? Yo-Yo says, the fish disappeared from the kitchen a short while ago. What was that swallowing? That means the thief who stole the fish is underneath us. What? I didn't know. All right, I'll go and catch him, Bosray says. We can get through now. Maybe it is a separate person. A man's voice says, Chris. Yes? Chris? Yo-Yo, did you just call me? No, it wasn't me. Chris? Yo-Yo? I heard someone calling me, too. This way, this way. Is that Bosray? I mean, we should be able to recognize his voice. We were just talking to him. Oh, who's that? Uncle Huck! It's nice to see you again. It's truly a twist of fate. Let me guess, you're the thief. How did you get here? Chris asked. Ha ha ha, I just told you it's an inevitable twist of fate. I no longer have use of the loan shark because he doesn't understand my research. A scholar must continue his journey forward with a curious mind. That's why I got onto this ship. Uncle Huck, Chris says, it's just an excuse. You ran away because you couldn't pay him back, right? Yo-Yo says, you are stowing yourself away. Ha ha ha, boy, don't worry about little things. You must make certain sacrifices to achieve your goal. Was it you, Uncle Huck? Did you steal the fish from the kitchen? If you did, you are a thief. No, you're mistaken. It wasn't me. Noise from stomach. Oh boy. His stomach gave him away. Huck's stomach is making noise. He must be very hungry. Okay, hungry. Not digesting fish. Okay, I guess there's a difference. Was that you, Uncle Huck? Yo-Yo says. See? This is the proof of my innocence. I may evade loan payments, but I will never steal from others. Well, in a way, you stole from the loan shark. But I guess it's a little bit of a delayed steal, right? Huck says, don't worry, Chris. Your uncle is an honest soul. More or less. Yo-Yo says, what should we do now? We must talk to Captain Jilba. Basri says, hey, I was looking for you. We found the fish with bite marks. It must be a rat. I want to go down there now. A rat? Yo-Yo says. Well, now I am proven innocent. Basri says, yeah, from the size of the bite marks, the rat must be huge. By the way, who are you? Hello, I am Huck, Chris's uncle and Moonlight Witch researcher. Thank you for taking care of my niece. My pleasure. Wait a minute, where'd you come from? Why are you here? Why? Because I was just sleeping there. There? At the back of the barrels. Yeah, somewhere around there. Are you sure? I was here all day, but I didn't notice you. I was sleeping, so I didn't notice you either. Chris, what are we gonna do? Uncle Huck? Chris says, you are just like my father said you were. Anyway, Basri says, we can't let you go because you smuggled yourself onto this ship. Come with me to the captain's room. I want to go down to the third deck or whatever, or fourth, actually. I understand the situation, Captain says. I didn't know he was Chris's uncle. Sorry, guys. I'm sorry, Captain Jilba, Chris says. I didn't have any time or money, but everything I do is to seek the truth about the Moonlight Witch. Uncle! Oops. I'm sorry. The Captain says, you just stowed yourself away and we already know who you are, so I don't think we should make a big fuss about it. Chris asks, but will he be charged? Well, not quite. The captain has the authority to deal with cases like this. Your uncle must stay in his room until we arrive at the port of Neri. If we don't have any more problems until Neri, then we won't charge him. Thank you, Captain Jilba. Is that clear, Mr. Huck? The captain says. If you say so. Uncle! I mean, thank you for your generosity. Captain says, Basri, take Mr. Huck to cabin number 6. After that, return to your work in the ship's hold. Keep the key with you. Yes, sir. He's supposed to come with him. Hey, you, Chris's uncle, you're in no position to go sightseeing. Was he about to go back in, or he's listening at the door? I don't know. Kriyoyo says, thank you so much, Captain Jilba. Chris says, thank you. Don't mention it. I don't think your relative is a bad person. I can tell by watching you two. By the way, Yuria, what happened to the situation with Loji? Have you found anything? Actually, Loji was not the only victim. Mr. Heston also lost a gold brooch. Mr. Heston, too? I don't want to believe it, but a disguised bandit may have sneaked onto our ship. What is a disguised bandit? It's a thief who pretends to be a traveler and steals valuables from other travelers. Wow, Chris says. I believe we received wanted notices from Folthia and Menarth. Yayo, those notices are on the bookcase. Could you read them to me? Okay. We may find some clues from the wanted notices. Okay, he's no longer by the door. The uncle. Yayo, Chris, I'm still talking. Well, you stopped talking so I could read you this stuff. There are two notices. Which one would you like to read? Wanted notice, Ruta. Wanted, young burglar couple. Wanted thief number 86, male. Number 87, female. Names are unknown, but always work as a pair. They're a good-looking couple. Sounds like our friends in the cabin next door. Goose and Shilpa? She's a master of disguise, and he is a cat burglar. They often fail in their attempts because of their big mouths. Captain says, read the wanted notice from Nelva, too. Wanted thief number A14, male, disguises as a middle-aged gentleman, responsible for many crimes. Sounds like Uncle Hawk. He is basically a loner, but suspected to have ties with an organized crime gang. Good at planning and caution. Cases involving the use of sleeping pills have been reported. Sleeping pills on other people or himself, because he was sleeping behind barrels. The captain says, well, the couple in the wanted notice from Rudo. It bothers me. Chris says, do you think so too? I have been suspecting that couple for a while. It's strange they haven't showed up even once after the ship left. Right. They're so suspicious. Yuri says, but we shouldn't suspect people easily. Don't be too nice, Chris says. People are getting their things stolen. Once we arrive at Neri, they'll run away. We must do something before then. Chris is absolutely right, guys. Captain says, I'll ask them to show themselves. It's my duty to protect the belongings of my passengers. I must ask them to comply. Don't ask them, tell them. Yuri-O, Chris, come with me. Let's bring Bulto with us, just in case. Is Bulto a good-built gentleman? Well-built? Excuse me, I'm Captain Jilba. Is anyone in the room? Oh no, it's the captain this time, Goose says. Excuse me, this is Jilba. Shirley says yes. May I help you? You haven't come out of the room. Are you feeling all right? Yes, my partner is seasick. That's not good. I will have someone bring some motion sickness pills. They're effective, so he'll get better soon. Thank you very much, Goose says. We're in trouble. We haven't stolen anything yet. We can't be caught now. Okay, so they're not the thieves? They're saying they haven't stolen anything yet. So the mystery is still afoot. Captain says, hey, you. Can you go to the captain's room and bring some motion sickness pills? You'll find them on the left side of the shelf. Yes, sir. Bring them quickly. They are on the shelf next to the one with the wanted notices. I want to believe them. Bulto says, I will help you if something happens. I can carry 3 barrels at once. I am proud of my muscle. It's too funny. We must get some medicine quickly, Chris says. I can't try to go in the room. Alright, let's go back. Get the medicine. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I guess we won't dally about. We'll just go get it. Left side, he says, of something. Here they are, Chris says. Yuri-O says, strange. All the motion sickness pills are gone. You're right. There's nothing left. Captain Jilba must have missed it. I guess many guests are suffering from seasickness. Those might have been stolen as well. Let's go back to see the captain first, Yuri-O says. I kind of feel like wondering if anyone else have any new lines to say. We have no motion sickness pills? I remember there was a lady who had a very bad seasick in the last trip. Ask the captain. He knows where the stash is. I'm pretty sure we did find the stash. Yo-Yo, you didn't tell me what the captain's order was, Garten says. I'm sorry, was he mad at you? No, not that bad, but be careful next time. Was I supposed to talk to him before something else, doing something else? I'm wondering now. Let's just check in on this guy again. See if he knows anything about motion sickness pills. It's almost tea time. I was making tea. Chris says, smells good. Yuria says, I'm sorry, Mr. Heston, but I haven't found your gold brooch yet. Oh, that. Don't worry about it. By the way, would you like to join me? Tea will be ready soon. Thank you, but I've got a job that the captain asked me to do. That's too bad. Well, maybe next time. I want the bag. Nothing new there. Nothing new there. This guy's still asleep. The sleeping pills. Right, they said it was a problem with the the second notice of the third criminal using sleeping pills. That was the one disguised as a middle-aged gentleman. Did you find the motion sickness pills? Captain says. Captain Jill, but the bottle was empty. Are you sure? It's my fault. Sorry. You've got some stashes in the far corner of the ship's hold downstairs. Can you bring them to me? Oh, yeah. I want to go down there. Far corner of the ship's hold downstairs. Yes, the farthest corner. Thank you. You have anything else to say? Watch your steps because it's dark inside the ship's hold. Okay. Uncle Huck! Huck says, do you feel lonely without your uncle? I can bear loneliness, but I don't need any more trouble from you. You sound just like your father. Like father, like daughter. Badre says, you're going to the ship's hold to get some motion sickness pills? Be careful. There may be big rats hiding there. I should come with you, but I still have some work to do. Be careful. Oh, we can get to this way? We finally get to go down and see the mysterious hold. Oh boy. I bet you there's gonna be some battles down here. Wait. Yo-Yo, look! Wow, a fat rat and its fat kid. Its whiskers are tickling me. Must be trying to beg for food. Here, have some biscuits, Chris says. Chris, could I have some too? Sorry, that was the last one. Typical. Normal mood. Weak from hunger. Let's boost our defense in combat. Gulp down the stamina food. happy now. New data. Alright, so we're gonna see what's behind this door. Probably some battles. This place is a bit creepy, Yurio says. Yurio, you hated dark storerooms since you were a child. Let's find the pills and get back quickly. Chris, it says jerky on this wooden box. Are you hungry? I haven't had my lunch yet. Oh, I missed the walnut pies of Ragpick Village. So I'm not gonna take any jerky. Oh, there's rats. This barrel smells so good. Smells good? You have a strange accent there. Don't tell me you got drunk just by smelling the rum. Battle, wow. Giant rats encountered. Pets defense. Whee! Defense up. Yeah, I don't know why no valid targets with Wind Cutter. It only works against certain enemies or something like that. Yo-ho! And a bottle of rum. Yay! Well, I was glad for that. We've been missing the combat. Hasn't been for a while. Oh, his attack is full. Sword Fang. I'll show you what I've got! Sword Fang! Boom. Well, that was fun. Are you guarding the pills? Light cactus, which just looks like ice. So you get to use it. Oh, that's him. Kind of a waste since it's already damaged. Oh, her hit points are out. How'd that happen? Because I wasn't paying attention.